What a beautiful blessing and a boon this body is, and it is also a mystery. From a small headache to a boil, or to a little fracture, we all rush to a doctor, and the doctor unfolds the mystery behind this body. Welcome to Aware and Care. I'm Madhvi Batula. I'm joined by Dr. Ambika Nair, who is the chief consultant and co-founder of Shantigram Group of Companies. In the series Aware and Care, we inform our viewers and together learn about this mysterious thing called the body and learn to take care of it. Let's welcome Dr. Nair. Welcome to the show, Dr. Nair.
Thank you so much.
This is a season where the season is changing. Lots of things are happening around us, from a bug bite to the puberty or to a middle age to a menopause situation. The body goes through numerous changes all through the life. I'm told that about 200,000 people across USA face this condition that we're going to talk about. It is an inflammatory condition. It's very painful. And many times people think it's acne. Some people call it boils and some people call it pimples. But there is a terminology for it. What is that terminology?
You're talking about HS, I think.
Yes, that's what we're talking about.
Okay. Hidradenitis suppurativa.
Yes, hidradenitis and suppurativa. Okay.
That is suppurativa means pus formation, yeah.
Okay. It's a very, very mouthful of a disease name or a condition name, if I would want to correct myself there. So I would like to address it more as HS. So what is HS? Let's start from the basic of HS.
See, it is a very chronic inflammatory disease, actually. Mm-hmm. Because actually it is mostly seen in ladies, but it is seen in men also. At hand, I have like a handful of cases. Only one lady is there, rest all men. So I cannot tell that it is not seen in men. Okay. But mostly it is seen in ladies. That's what it is told. See, we all like sweat a lot. Okay. Our armpits and all, and the groin region. So, you know, like, you know, the smell of the sweat. Because some odor you cannot stand nearby. Mm-hmm. We always tell that, you know, especially while traveling in the public transports, you know, we will tell that, oh, we cannot, because that, because this, everybody uses a lot of perfumes now, but still the odor will be like a mixed odor, you know, like, so, because, see, there is an outlet. This is called outlet only because we have to sort out. Mm-hmm. But when it is blocked, because we call it as, you know, all the srotas is blocked in Ayurveda. So when it is blocked, so that becomes like lumps, okay. Small lumps. It can be like a pimple type also. It can be like even more according to the stage, okay. So like some people will tell that because I used to get a small pimple, but you know, like a small blackhead will be there, like a small one blackhead will be there. And you know, like because I ignore it, but if we press it, something will come out also, they will tell that, some white discharge or something like that. But that is not dangerous actually. Because there is an inflammation, but that can be taken care if you keep the area clean and everything. But when it goes beyond that, so that was the first stage. Small lumps you will see only on the axilla. Mm-hmm. Second stage means, you know, lumps will become bigger. It turns painful. You are unable to, because swelling will be there. You are unable to lift your hand. That is more, you know, like noticeable. Your movements are restricted there. You get like inflammation, like low grade fever, because there is an inflammation in the body. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then you can see that the redness is there, pus formation will be there. Okay. But you know, like there is no, like sometimes it will look like a carbuncle type, a little bit of, you know, like color changes and all. Mm-hmm. There comes pus ooze out. Very painful situation. You can always see that because there is, you know, like more, you know, like because the pus oozing will be there, it will be more like so many are there, not really because it can spread anywhere.
So basically you're saying this is, this condition comes mostly in places which are compact and covered mostly, like your underarms, under your breast, hairy. Groin, buttocks, hair. Or inner thighs.
Hair. Hairy areas actually. And not only that, you know, because in boys, I have seen that it is under the testicle also. Okay. And even they have done surgery for that actually. Mm-hmm. So that was very bad actually, very painful, very painful. Because the armpits, you know, like apocrine glands are there, but so much of gland is there for the sweats. when all the glands are blocked only, you know, like it will be so painful. It's very, you didn't see such cases. That's what, you know, like, you know how painful, and you know, they cannot go in public. Their social
life. How does this problem actually originate? Is it a genetic thing? Is it something to do with your hygiene? Or is it something to do with, you know,
causes can be, you know, like a little genetic will be there.
Okay.
But they will tell that, because there is no, specifically they cannot say that, because my, that two cases from the same family is there. So I asked about the history. So they told the father had skin issues. Okay, only the father had, but both the boys has it. So genetic issue is also there. Sometimes the hormonal imbalance. And, you know, but like too much sugar intake. Yeah, okay. Ask me.
What about immunity? Is it an immune-related issue?
It is an autoimmune disease, actually. Because it can happen to anybody, actually. There is nothing like that. Because the impaired fat molecules are deposited in the muscle fat, you know, like, because that only become, like, it will become swollen and very painful. Okay. Especially in the breast area, under the breast, under the, if you are obese, you know, under your, you know, like your tummy, in between that, all the thighs, all the groin, armpits, and in between the buttocks, because you cannot sit. Because I know how the patients will tell, you know, like, because they cannot sit, especially, you know, in IT and all, you know, they have to sit for a long time. So that area will never get, you know, like, better. Rest, everything has gone. So this one was complaining only that. I told him, what I will do, I cannot ask you to lie down. And, you know, when they came to me, he was unable even to sit and do. So he used to work on his computer by lying down.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So, doctor, you just mentioned about the reasons or possibilities of how this could actually come. Is there also a possibility that there is an underlying condition which could lead to this? Like, you, I think you just totally mentioned diabetes. Or is there any other condition because of which this could come, or there's no reason?
No, see, if they are like, because some in other cases, you know, like they are treated with, they are treated in allopathy in a different way.
Okay.
So many medications. So drug-induced diabetes, it can lead to obesity. If the person is obese, we tell them to reduce their weight. Okay, so there are so many, you know, like those things, and depression, fear, because such conditions, you cannot meet people. Youngsters, you know, because I have seen in youngsters, maybe because of the stress, it is very lot, actually. Stress is too much, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Sleep, if they don't sleep properly.
Are there any stages on this particular condition that it just comes in a small portion, or it just slowly progresses into big, it disappears and comes back again?
No, it doesn't disappear, actually. It is only camouflaged. It will just go down a little bit. You know, that's what I told you. The first stage, it will be very small, you know, like a lump or something like that. You feel that, you know, like you ignore it sometimes because it does not, you know, like then it started giving, you know, like people think that, oh, the small acne is there.
Mm-hmm.
Then it started like becoming very big. It can appear in different parts of the body, only on the axilla area or all those groins. Especially hair follicle areas, actually.
Hair follicles.
Okay, so this all, in Ayurveda, we call it, then only the pus formation comes.
So there is an absence, like there is oozing, there is all kind of things
too
happening.
Too much oozing, too much oozing.
So is it contagious by any chance?
No. People, they ask me, you know, like when they come to me, they ask, is it contagious? Can we go near to the patient? Of course, you can go near to the patient. Mm-hmm. That it is never contagious. Never you will get it. Don't worry for that.
Okay. So, and you also mentioned there's a strong odor which comes out from these absence or these things. So how does somebody curtail that even to function, try to function on a normal basis?
Try to function normal. They will function, but they will be little, because they always keep little isolation. You understand?
Okay.
They try to avoid, because actually because of the smell, you have to clean that area. See, that is, you know, like a how to manage the case. Because, you see, it will not be cured 100%.
Okay.
Okay, so that is also there. It can be managed. It so be further managed. Deterioration, you know, like, because if you really take care of your food habits, if you take care of your health, you know, like whatever, because when anybody comes to us, you know, we will tell that if they are obese, we will ask their, you know, like their history also, because these things, you know, some people will think that it is only an acne. you know, like when it comes also, but some people get like acne vulgaris also, you know, like on the face and everything. Mm-hmm. So multiple issues they will be having it, and very painful thing. Very painful it is actually. Your movements are restricted actually.
So think how what the symptoms are, how it comes. And of course, we are looking at managing this condition. So we have a patient who has come to Shantigram clinic with this condition. And you will do a detailed analysis of his body type and composition and food habits and other aspects of it.
Yes.
The first thing which would come to anybody's mind is to manage the pain and then go for the treatment, because your mind blocks up when the pain is at such high intensity. So do you recommend them to take painkillers, or they do take painkillers for that?
They will take painkillers. No need to tell them.
So do the painkillers actually work for them?
Yeah, the painkiller will not. Because actually it is like a big abscess, you understand now. So it wants to burst out to me, so naturally the pain will be there. So mm-hmm. we tell them to do the hot fermentation, mm-hmm. okay, and the application of heat, cleaning the area properly, and keep it dry, because the sweat glands are there now. So we even tell them, you know, like apple cider vinegar, you know, like you can dilute it and apply over there, mm-hmm. so that the odor comes down, and it is antibacterial also. It helps a lot actually.
Okay. So I think this is some of the treatment methods that you've just mentioned. We would like to continue more on that, as to what happens during the treatment, what are the complications people face, or what are the discomforts they face, and what you would recommend and suggest to the patients who come for this treatment.
Because actually, you know, like when the people will come, you know, like because we will see whether what is their dosha. 90% is pitta and the kapha doshas only. Okay, so then only, you know, like all these abscesses comes. Because when the srotas is blocked, when the channel is blocked naturally, so we try to do the panchakarma for them. Mm-hmm. Okay, sneha panam, so that's a detoxification. Mm-hmm. So the toxins will come out from the body. But some people, they react, you know, like they come with very bad cases, you know, like and they after the therapies, like 14 days and all, they feel much better. The odor comes down like after 3-4 days, because very difficult situation to take such cases itself. Then, you know, they really respond to the treatment very fast. We tell them what to eat, what not to eat. Mm-hmm. You know, like all the milk and milk products, dairy products, we abruptly stop it actually.
Okay.
Yeah, that is more important in this. And we make them 100% vegetarian, because we don't want any toxin to be induced in the body while doing the therapies actually. And the cutting of sugar, less fatty food. Okay, if you know, like the diet, we always give like more leafy vegetables.
That so diet helps to cleanse the body and detoxify the body.
Natural way, it will come.
And what about the general hygiene conditions? Because in such a painful conditions, with so much of oozing and pain and other stench coming out, personal hygiene is a must. The family life gets abrupted and disrupted there. So what kind of hygiene routine do you tell them to, you know, put some lotions or creams or oils in the shower or water that they are cleansing?
No. Only wash with the soap and water.
Only soap and water. Okay.
Only soap and water. And we don't allow them to use mild soap actually. Like mm-hmm. there are so many antibacterial soaps are also there, you know, like otherwise I told, you know, like a little bit of spirit, methylated spirit, they can dilute it with water and they can wash that area and keep that dry.
Okay. But doctor, you're just mentioning a couple of times that you have to keep the that part dry, wherever this abscess is, wherever this boil is. Now, what about dressing it? I mean, if there's oozing happening, how does both go hand in hand? You want to keep it dry also, and you want to clean it and keep it.
They will put a pad over there, like the dressing parts are there. Mm-hmm. So they put it and they will go. Because otherwise, how will you expect them to go? They cannot even move. Okay. That bad it is. And first of all, they get into depression very fast. Why I am suffering? Because 1% of the population has this problem. And it is very, you know, like they will have like migraine sometimes. All this, you know, like because of there is an inflammation inside the body. Yeah.
So I'm sure with a condition like this, my next question could be a little silly, but still I would want to know what kind of fabric people should be using. And of course, deodorant would definitely be a no, but yet there are people who still try to use it so that they feel a little comfortable and fresh.
No, I told you, because soap and water, and they can use the alcohol only.
we talk about traffic, what kind
deodorant is okay, but if it is like a, but you know, overuse of all those things, it will actually block the channel, block the area. Yeah.
And what kind of exercise routines would you recommend to them to start, maybe?
Surya Namaskar, so that, you know, like if the, because that rubbing of the buttocks will be there, like, you know, like the thigh will be there, you know, because the arms will become like this, very big. Okay, so that, you know, like if they lose their weight, they will feel much better, actually.
Oh, they have to lose their weight.
I
see somebody putting a question and asking, what about talcum powder? Many traditionally people use to dry up the space with talcum
but,
powder.
I don't advise for that.
So Dr. Nair, we're talking about HS today and you've given so much of information. And as you mentioned, it's a manageable condition. I definitely am sure that our viewers are looking forward for some home remedies before they reach out to you. People always want to try something at home. So what is your suggestion for the viewers?
Aloe vera they can use, even they can use for cleaning also.
Okay.
Like an astringent also, they can use that actually. Mm-hmm. Then, you know, like if they are smoking, don't smoke. Okay. And amla is very good. Our Indian gooseberry. Apple cider vinegar, they can use a little bit with the water, but dilute in water and take. And do the regime, like do little yoga every day morning. That is more important. Because you have to do. Physically, you have to be fit.
Sorry? Please go ahead.
Physically, you have to be fit.
We have to be fit. Now, this is a problem which definitely, like any other health condition, gets into the mind space. So we definitely want to hear from you. What is your message for the family members of a patient who's suffering?
It is manageable. Madhavi, it is manageable. It's not that, because only thing that, you know, we don't take care, it will become very worse.
Okay.
People will think that anyway, theek nahi hone ka hai, why to go to the doctor? That is not the attitude. Mm-hmm. You should go and take it. In Ayurveda, we have very good medications also. Very good herbs are there. And really, we take care of them. And worst conditions, you know, like they come and they are happy. They get connected to me also. Mm-hmm. If anything like that, we can take care of you all.
Awesome.
Whoever has this problem.
That is some hopeful words from our favorite doctor, Dr. Ambika Nair from Shantigram. And of course, you know that there is virtual consultation and in-clinic consultation also happening. The website is there on your screen. Please do take the appointments and always have the conversation and see all the options that are available. And all the conditions that we've spoken to date, we've always asked the question first, whether, you know, doctor, this is manageable, controllable, avoidable. All those aspects, Dr. Ambika Nair is kind enough to explain to us that certain conditions are manageable, and I think HS is one of them. So if you are facing this condition, feel free to reach out to the doctor and her team and they will take care of you. Your final words, Dr. Nair?
Yeah, because these lesions, you know, because it's like a fibrosis, you know, like because that become very difficult for them, you know, that's what I told. Do the exercises, because that is more important. People get, you know, like they get frustrated. Mm-hmm. Why I am suffering? Why my friends are not suffering? Mm-hmm. See, for everybody, it is written what to suffer. This is all your karma. So don't worry. But how to come out, that should be your attitude.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you all will be fine. If you have any problem like this, think that you will be perfectly all right. All the disease is in your hands. So don't lose the confidence. This is my message for everybody, especially during this Navratra season.
Mm-hmm. That is such a beautiful message from our doctor, Dr. Ambika Nair. Today we are talking about hidradenitis suppurativa. I still have to get a mouthful of that particular problem. But then nevertheless, there is hope. There are remedies. There are comfort medicines available through Ayurveda. And that is what this entire program is about, aware and care. So if there's any health condition that you want us to talk about, feel free to text, call, email, or reach out to the clinic. And we will take up the topic in our next session. Until next time, be aware and take care of yourself. Thank you, Dr. Nair. This is a delight.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.